In this video, we'll create our first text ad. We're on the Content tab, and we'll be working in this area here. We're going to create an ad variation template. Each ad group can contain any number of ad variation templates. And each of these templates can contain up to 4 keyword category placeholders. Each placeholder is replaced by a keyword when AdWords Campaign Manager generates the text ads. Thus, you can generate a text ad for every possible combination of keywords in the keyword list. First, we choose our keyword fields to include in the text ad. Keyword 1 will be pay-per-click. Keyword 2 will be advertising. Keyword 3 will be guide. We shan't need 4 keyword categories for this ad variation. To help you stay within Google's line length limits, AdWords Campaign Manager tells you what the longest words are in each category and how many characters they have. If you click on a label in AdWords Campaign Manager, you select all the text in its text box. I've typed a headline for our text ad, Google AdWords Information. This is the longest possible line using keyword 3. Until you become familiar with AdWords Campaign Manager, it's a good idea to design your text ad by typing the longest possible keywords first, and then replacing them with the keyword placeholders, as we'll see in just a moment. Once you're used to the software, you should be able just to go ahead and type the placeholders themselves. Google considers the headline as very important for determining the relevance of text ads to the keywords that match the search term typed by surfers. For best results, therefore, the headline should contain as many keywords as possible. Press the Tab key to move to the first description line and type pay-per-click advertising information. These are the 3 longest keywords strung together. Press the Tab key again to move to the second description line and type beginner to expert to superhuman. Marketing tests show that the best results are from text ads that contain a feature of the product or service in the first description line and a benefit in the second description line. This is only one of many possible ad variation templates in this ad group. Our next ad variation template, for example, might use the word novice instead of the word beginner in the second description line. Press the Tab key to move to the Display URL text box and type the URL that you want to appear in the text ad. I've typed www.adwordscampaign.net. This URL is only for show and has no effect. Tab once more to the Destination URL text box and type the full web address of the landing page. http://www.adwordscampaign.net. Give this ad variation a meaningful name, something that will distinguish it from other ad variations in this ad group. This name will be suggested as a file name when you come to save this ad variation in a file so that you can find it again easily to load it. I've called it Beginner, Expert, Superhuman. Now it's time to insert the keyword placeholders, starting with the headline. In this case, our first two keywords, Google and AdWords, have no alternatives and therefore don't need placeholders. The third keyword, however, does have alternatives such as guide, strategy, etc. So select information. Check which category it's in. The keyword information is in the guide category, which is keyword 3. So with the keyword information selected, click the keyword 3 button. The actual keyword is replaced by the keyword 3 placeholder, which looks like this. Now let's do the same with the keywords in the first description line. Select pay-per-click. Check which category it's in. It's keyword 1. And click the keyword 1 button. Advertising. Is keyword 2. So click the keyword 2 button. Information is keyword 3. So click the keyword 3 button. As you can see, our first description line contains nothing but keyword placeholders. Google will love it. We could put keywords in the second description line and the display URL if we wanted to. This ad variation, however, will contain static text in these lines. Now, what about Google's line length limits that I mentioned earlier? This max column here indicates the number of characters left to use in each line before the limit is reached. If the line has a negative number, its length will exceed Google's limit by that number of characters. This presents no problem for AdWords Campaign Manager. Down here, we have a section, Default Text to Use if a keyword makes a line too long. And we type in these text boxes the default text to be used instead of the keywords that make the line exceed Google's maximum limit. We see here that the longest generated headline will be one character too long with keyword 3. AdWords Campaign Manager tells us that the longest keyword 3 is information, and that it's 11 characters in length. So, all we need to do is click the keyword 3 label and type default text that is at least one character shorter than 11 characters. I'm going to use the word advice. AdWords Campaign Manager tells us that this default text contains only 6 characters. So that's fine. Now, whenever AdWords Campaign Manager generates a headline that's too long, it'll replace the keyword 3 placeholder with the word advice. We also see that the first description line will be 2 characters too long. If we leave things as they are, the keyword 3 placeholder will be replaced with the default text for keyword 3. This means that the word information will be replaced with the word advice. We already discovered in an earlier video that the word information is very popular in search terms. So I really do want this word information to appear somewhere in my text ad. This is no problem at all for AdWords Campaign Manager, and is just one of its features that makes it a unique piece of software. In the first description line, I'd prefer the keyword one placeholder to be replaced with default text rather than the keyword three placeholder. To make that happen, all I do is set the priority of keyword 3 to 1 in the default priority section here. The priority of keyword 1 automatically changes to 3. Now, when AdWords Campaign Manager generates a text ad whose first description line is too long, it'll replace the keyword 1 placeholder before the keyword 3 placeholder. I want the keyword 1 default text to be AdWords. So now, instead of the longest description appearing as pay-per-click, advertising, advice, it will be displayed as AdWords, advertising, information. AdWords Campaign Manager suppresses duplicates in its output, so there can never be identical text ads created by using default text. Although keyword 2 default text will never be needed in this particular instance, I'll type the word ad in here just for completeness. There's no keyword 4 in this ad variation template, so we can ignore that altogether. To finish off, choose the type of capitalization you want. Watch the facsimile change here. There's a choice of first word only, keywords only, or all words. I'm not a fan of all words being capitalized, so I'll choose keywords only. Set the default ad variation status here. Usually it'll be left as active. I'll set this ad variation to paused, though, because this is only a demonstration and I don't want this campaign to be live in my Google account when I upload it. This ad variation is now complete. Let's click the Save Ad button and accept the default file name, which is taken automatically from the name of the ad variation. Click the Save button. Oh, by the way, if you click the headline in the facsimile, the destination website will be displayed in your default browser. See you in the next video. We'll generate these text ads and upload the campaign to Google.